to my reaction to episode 11 of Fruits Basket Season 2 Remake. Last episode was the end of the vacation arc, I guess, where a ton happened. I don't think I need to recap everything. You've seen it. But I guess the main thing is Kyo and Yuki seem to have gotten stronger. There's a lot of intrigue about Akito, Rin, and I'd say that's about it for now. Yeah, I mean, there's still so many answers that I'd like to get about Akito, but still, we're not even halfway through the season, and there's still season 3, so. Anyway, enough talking. I'm sure you can tell, but some of the last reaction, a lot of them were when I was way more awake, but today I just woke up really fucked up. Anyway, episode 11, let's get into this in 3, 2, 1. I mean, this kind of house is easy to break into anyway. She's gonna call best girl. Of course. I'm sure you'll change it. You'll change that. Quick, I was thinking we were not going to address all that stuff for a bit. Because he constantly break their will. Fair enough. Oh, well, I guess, yeah, it came to a full realization of his feelings, so makes sense. It's a very weird necklace. Okay, so she's also trying to fight that. The trip was big. I was going to say, look like egg. Okay, I mean. There is a lot of bad stuff, but still. was she scared? Is the question. I see. So that's why she's a apologetic. Relatable. Find someone who's in a worse situation than you to make you feel better. I mean, there's not too much shame in that. Tolu is like the one in a billion case, you know. Most people are like that. I like Kagura. Could at least say, just I'm not in love with you. Rather than I'll never fall in love with you. No, she's actually in love, of course. This was good, very good. Man, alright. I wasn't expecting to keep being that serious right from coming back from the trip, to be honest. I thought we were going to be getting a bit of a, you know, more comedy centric blowing off steam episode after the very, very, very serious arc that was the vacation arc. But this is good. I mean, I didn't think this would happen so quick, the Kagura arc, but yeah, this is good stuff. As I said before, well, she thinks it's absolutely disgusting, etc., etc. A feeling of, you know, when you're in a bad situation and you see someone that's seemed to be in a worse situation than you I guess feel better in the sense that you can tell yourself you're not the worst. You some people are a bit worse than you. It's just very understandable, basic human psychology shit, you know. Of course I've gone through that. I guess quite simple case when I was bullied back in school, you know, and there was a guy that was bullied even worse than me. It just, you know, I kind of looked down on him, trying to tell myself that yeah, I was still better than him, but in the end, both of us were bullied, you know, and were treated like shit, you know. But since he seemed to be more bullied than me and shittier dealing with it than me, I just felt kind of like, you know, I'm better than this guy at least. Just, you know, classic human psychology shit of trying to make yourself feel better and dealing with shit. So I don't think it's, you know, I don't think Kagura is bad for any of that. It's understandable. And I mean, as I said before, Toru is like a goddess of perfection and all that. I don't think it's a bad thing that you would run away when you see that form in the first place, because it is a scary monster form, you know. Obviously that would hurt Kyo, but it's reasonable too that you would run away. So yeah, this is good. I mean, yeah, just very quick, we come back and instantly Kagura seem to go through an arc. Kyo too, I guess. Well, he already went through the arc. Now he's got the resolve, you know. He knows he loves Toru. Yeah. Really good stuff. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.